Heather S. Hi, guys. Love catching these shows live. You guys are a hilarious duo. Thanks for always keeping me laughing.
We try. Well, we're actually trying to make you educated. We're trying to actually teach you some stuff. So start learning now. Crooked pictures and all. Hey, everybody. How are you? Welcome to the show. You want to make sure we got sound there?
Oh, shoot. I got to pull it up on my phone.
Yeah, you got to sort of do your, you sort of got to participate in the show. Hey, everybody. How are you? Jeff Gellman, a solid canine training. Linda is out sick. She's, which way? One room over. Joelle's pinch hitting. But we're back in Providence. So normally the show is starts out with Linda, who's on Joelle. Joelle's nice enough to come here a little bit early and jump in onto that. And it's been a great trip. We got back late last night. And started at 4:30 this morning, ready to go, hit the gym. And this is the way, this is what we're going to do. Hey, Melissa, how are you? Thanks for being on. This is how we're going to do things. First, I'll give you a little bit of spiel, who I am and what I do. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and I've got a training facility up in Providence, Rhode Island. In Providence, Rhode Island, we specialize in aggression rehab and behavior modification. So that means we work with some really challenging dogs. We obviously can train your dog basic on-leash and off-leash obedience, but our big thing is stopping unwanted behaviors. And the reason why I'm talking about stopping unwanted behaviors is because you're going to hear me talk a lot about punishment on this show. And if you're brand new to my world, I use terms like shock collar. You can call them a remote collar if you want to. And we use punishment. You can call it a correction if you want to. But the proper term actually is punishment. And punishment is not bad. I'm actually trying to redefine or actually define properly what it really is. And there's a proper way to do it, and people need to understand how to properly do it. The only way that you can stop unwanted behavior is through the proper application of punishments. That's it. You can yell, you can scream, you can feel differently. The bottom line is facts just don't care about your feelings. That's just the way it is. And most people will ask me on this show, how do I stop? And then fill in the blank, and I'll actually tell you. Ironically, on the flip side, 90% of our training center every day, four trainers, we're working with dogs, probably between all four trainers, 800 to 1,000 times a day, the yes word is said, and we rarely hear the no word. So it's about 90-10, 90 yes, 10% no. And it's probably even less than that on some days. There might even be days where we don't even have to say no to a dog. So here we go. Also, there's a super chat. If you go down below, some people are confused about how do they ask a question. You should see your name, your screen name. Like I see Solid Canine Training at the bottom of my screen. And then it says, say something. And then if I put in hello, everybody sees hello, everyone. And then right below that, you got a little emoji there. But then next to that, you got a little dollar sign. Now the dollar sign, dollar, dollar, make you holla. So you want to make a screen tonight? No, there will not be any naked men walking behind us. And if you missed that, you might want to turn into the last show because I don't know about you, but I watched that like 20 times, you know, rewind, play. I can appreciate a good looking man like the rest of us can. The money gets used for date night for Linda and myself. Probably going to be used for medicine though this week because everybody is sick. So while we were away, Linda and all three kids were sick. And today it's Linda's day to not get out of bed, Angela's day to not get out of bed. So it's been an interesting trip. So here we are, we're back and we're ready for action. So
ready,
Joelle, let's go. And also when you do the dollar sign, the super chat, your question goes up to the top of the screen. We most likely will not get through all of the questions next.
Gal Jez. Hey, Jeff, how are you? Do I need to do one-on-one training, walk with my dog, and then later on taking him again to do his needs with my other dog, or doing both at the same time?
Depends on your skills. Depends on your skill set. I mean, it'll probably be easier for you to do one-on-one and then throw in the other dog. But if you got a good skill, like we would do that, like I would do that. You know, if we got a brand new dog in, we started working with it. If I was the beginning of my dog training journey, I would absolutely do that. Highly recommended. Just remember, though, you don't need to do a 30-minute, 45-minute walk. You can just go up and down the block really slow, do directional changes, work on slowing down, walking fast, turning right, turning left, getting that dog to really, really tune in with you. Next.
Melissa says, hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Melissa, glad you're here.
Leanne says, hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Leanne, how are you?
Double Agent says, hello.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
Next.
Greg, hey guys, just wondering which model cameras you use around your training facility. New neighbors, new dogs, fence wars will start soon.
So Greg, we use the Canon. We have a 5T or a 6T now? 5T? I think we got the 5T. Hold on. We've got a couple of them. I've got a bunch of them, and I'm actually going to be buying more. I'm actually buying a bunch of sound equipment.
Does he mean cameras and like security cameras though?
Oh, security cameras?
He says around the facility.
Oh, geez. I don't know. Something on Amazon. 16 cameras. 16 camera unit from Amazon. I don't know. Whatever it is. Next.
Mary says, hello, Jeff and friend.
Hey, hey man. Her name is Joelle, and we're not friends. All right? We work together. We're friends.
He pays me to be here. Allie Wynn. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Sorry you are sick, Linda. See you guys or your team, I guess, tomorrow.
Oh, Allie.
I'll be there.
Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. Allie, you should have gotten an email from me last night. I think I took care of that. Next. I went through all my emails. It might have been this morning. I caught up on my emails. Next.
Nicole. Hi. Glad you made it back safely.
You're glad. I'm glad. Linda's glad. The training center's glad. Next.
I'm glad.
Yes.
Double Agent says, that's right.
That's right. Next.
Josh. Hi, my 8-foot jumping 8-month-old GSC has not done it for a long time. I thought I could trust her and she jumped over a fence and ran into the intersection.
Whoa!
I had to not chase her, sit down and recall her back. It was pretty scary. She had been really good about not jumping over the fence for about 1.5 months. I usually let her out on a long line, except for just right now.
All right. So yeah. What I would do is this, remote collar on the dog. You might want to put hot wire on the fence or coyote rollers on the fence, or you might want to put underground fence 3 feet away from that fence. But I would put a remote collar on that dog, and anytime that dog went towards that fence, I would make sure I would hit that anti-jumping over the fence button for 3 seconds. And that's on 100 for 3 seconds. Got it? And it's not pretty. You shouldn't enjoy it. But boy, scraping your dog off the street sure as hell ain't going to be pretty, and you sure as hell ain't going to enjoy that. Next.
Heather S. Hi, guys. Love catching these shows live. You guys are a hilarious duo. Thanks for always keeping me laughing.
We try. Well, we're actually trying to make you educated. We're trying to actually teach you some stuff, so start learning now. Got a $4.99. $4.99 is from Grant. Grant, Joelle, what are some of your favorite parts about working with solid canine training? Also, what's something that are some things that are challenging but rewarding? What the fuck, Grant? Are you writing a newspaper article? Private message her on Instagram like everybody else does. Joelle, answer the man's question because he's still on board. We didn't scare him away.
Good. I'm glad you're going
to
come.
Grant, just to let you know, man, we made a good video of you, buddy, and we're monetizing the hell out of it. With the money we make from that video, Grant, I'm taking you out to a really nice dinner when you come into town. So thank you so much. Next. So
that's going to be on next week's. So, all right. So my favorite thing about working, my team, everybody there is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You guys
are pretty solid.
We've got a really good team. And then, what's something that are challenging but rewarding? Dealing with me.
Yeah. I don't even know if it's rewarding.
The rewarding. 3 years from now, it'll be rewarding.
Yeah.
You actually, though, you got to, I'm not going to answer for you, but go ahead.
Challenging. I mean, every day something else.
How did you really get challenged at the beginning?
It was just him putting on me all the time, like in just everything. Like I don't know. I'm on the spot now. See this stuff when I get put on the spot all constantly. Right.
This just goes to show. this goes to show how hard it is to do a freaking show. That's why Everybody thinks they can do a show.
Yep.
It's so funny, people. It's Grant, buddy, we love you. By the way, we love you. Welcome back and glad you're still with us. It's really funny because I just came back from I just did two seminars on the road. Combined seminars, we did 110 people. That's my 137th seminar about. So a lot of people out there that love to bash my seminars, love to bash me. You know, who's this guy doing the seminar? Rah, 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 rah. And my answer is this, I'm the guy doing the seminar. But I've got a good thing. I'm in the voluntary paid business. Does that make sense? All my seminars are under voluntary paid. And what I would encourage people to do is this. And I talk about this all the time about my haters. And I've got a lot of haters. I talk about this all the time. Instead of spending energy hating on me, that energy can be used to making helpful blog posts, taking photos with good descriptions, or making helpful videos to help educate people that actually need help. Now, you can do that. Also, if there's anybody out there that doesn't think I should be doing seminars, number one, don't go to them. Keep bashing me though, because just to let you know, I just want everyone to know how social media works, because we track all this stuff. I can't tell you how many people come to my seminars, literally, that give me money. Anything from my $500 seminars to my $4,000 week-long seminars that found out about me from somebody bashing me. Probably to the tune of an extra $75,000 a year. Like, my seminars do well, and they really do. My seminar series, they do extremely well. And people bashing me generate me a huge amount of revenue, a humongous amount of revenue. I mean, just scale this. But this is the thing. If somebody out there wants to do a dog training seminar, there's actually not enough. Okay, millions of dogs are dying. So many families are struggling. People need help. I encourage anybody out there to do a seminar, but keep this in mind. You have to find a location. You have to promote and advertise the seminar. You have to then organize the seminar. Then you have to stand up for 9 hours a day for 2 days at a minimum. And you have to work anywhere from 15 to 20 dogs. You have to know the answer to every single question. You don't take breaks. You can have anywhere there from 20 to 50 people there. And you have to be able to have dogs lunge at you, bite you. You have to know how to handle fearful, nervous, anxious, excited, aggressive dogs, literally that you just met 3 minutes prior. You have to be able to shut down 15 to 20 dogs within the first 10 minutes of the seminar so you can actually speak. And you always have to be on. So just keep that in mind. Then you have to be able to speak and enunciate and clearly get your message across to people that have paid a lot of money to be there. And you have to help people on the spot. You have to do, not just talk. You have to be able to communicate with people in a way that they understand. And you don't alienate them, shame them, or bash them. And you have to be professional at all times. It's challenging for people to do. What's easy for people to do is to sit back and criticize the ones that are doing it. And then you have the seminar people that like to bash too, and that's just professional jealousy. So I don't, that's just nonsense. Now what's happening out there on social media is this. And I just say this because I'm really trying to help people. Even the people that hate me, I want to be able to help you as much as I can. If you're a fellow dog trainer out there and you feel the need to bash other dog trainers, including me, keep doing me because I monetize the fuck out of that. I want you to say, I love looking at a naked woman. I can appreciate a naked man, but I love looking at a naked woman. I get very excited when somebody bashes me because all I can do is close my eyes and think about guaranteed cash flow. Now the marketplace though doesn't look at it that way. The marketplace, what they do is when they see another dog trainer comment negatively on a video, bash another trainer, what they do is they take a mental note of that and they say, I don't want to do business with you. I don't believe you. I don't want to know you. And I don't trust you. Literally the three things, know, like, and trust, that you need to establish rapport with somebody in order for them to actually have a voluntary transaction with you. So something to think about for all the folks out there that wake up every day with a chip on the shoulder, they love to hate. I want you to know you're going to lose in the long game. Next. $9.99. That looks like a David Smith.
That's David Smith for sure.
David Smith took Rocky to the pet store for distraction. Worried for a second about prong in public. Decided, fuck him like Jeff. No one said shit. Dog was great. Store owner impressed with behavior at 6 months. Love you. David, fucking rock star. Rock star, buddy. That attitude you have of fuck him. Guess what? Nobody ever comments to me in public about anything, ever. Funny how that is, right? Because I don't care. They know I'm the guy that doesn't care. Next.
Mel, my 18-month lab Rottweiler pup was biting dog heels when they were leaving dog daycare. The daycare started using an e-collar on her. I did not know this and made them stop when I found out. Now she lunges and barks on walks, is a window warrior, attacks the window in my car, broke my window, and barks at everyone coming to my house. She is not the nice dog she was before in proper collar use.
Okay, so Mel... So I would definitely have a, so just to let you know, is people go to us because they know how we train dogs. We're fully transparent. I find it very unethical that somebody would use a remote collar without the owner's permission. I find it very unethical. Now, I don't want to know the name of this company because it doesn't matter. It's more about an ethical question. It's a business practice question. If your dog got into a fight and they had to break up a dog fight, that's another story. They have to do whatever they can do. If they had to use a squirt bottle, which is another punisher, it's not the worst thing in the world. But putting on a remote collar without permission, without you knowing it, unless you did sign the contract that says, you might want to look back on your contract that says they can do it. But I'd like to think that they would tell you all the tools, techniques, and philosophies that they use. So. You can sit down with the owners. That can be fixed, though. Next.
Z Shad, picking up 8-week-old Golden Doodle tomorrow. I've heard you say that e-collar can be used at 14 weeks. I have a martingale and a slip lead. When would you introduce prong?
So what I want you to do is, first of all, the minute you pick up that dog, literally that dog should go into a crate in your car, not even on your lap. The training starts. Got it? The training starts. Pick up dog, go in crate, put in the car, drive home. I want you to get yourself a treat bag, a little treat pouch with a little belt. Amazon's got them. They've got a good one. And in there should be the dog's daily kibble. Okay? Get yourself a clicker. And also watch videos on how to properly clicker train a dog. Then what I want you to do is I want that dog to earn every bit of kibble. The dog should be in the crate for 20 hours a day, not continuously, but over the course of the day. 4 hours out, and actually 4 hours those first 2 weeks is probably pretty generous. That dog should have no free roaming, confine it to one room, let it drag around a leash, don't pick it up. Unless obviously it needs to get up steps and stuff, right? Next. So you can introduce a prong collar 14 weeks old. Next.
Double agent. Hello, Jeff. I'm buying a working dog, German show dog. Working dog, German show dog shepherd from Germany. Could that be a protection for my family?
That doesn't make sense, double agent. Working line or show line? You got two different lines there. I'd go with a working line. Make sure it's a working line. If the breeder's trying to sell you a working line show dog, I mean, that doesn't make sense. I mean, I guess you can have a working line dog that they use for shows, but usually working line, usually dog shows don't want the working line. They want the dog. They want, it's a different line. It's a different look of the dog. So I like a working line German shepherd from the Czech Republic. That's where I like to get my shepherds from. So, but you can get, I mean, I've got buddies over there that go over to Europe looking for dogs for personal protection, for military, and for sport. And a lot of these breeders, even those dogs, fail out. So, what I would do is, if you need a personal protection dog, I would actually probably find the trainer first and then get the dog. Next.
Lindsay, hey guys, doing great duration work with Leo, having trouble with his collar staying in place. It slides up his neck even though it's put on very tight. Is it okay to put it higher?
Yeah, it should go up really, really high. Also look at a bungee, like the bungee cord collars. So it's an aftermarket item that you put on, so it always wants to go snugger. Next.
Angela, have a one-year-old GSD. She is always looking at any shadows and any reflections. How do I get her to stop going after them? Please help.
So, Angela, make sure that you're not using a laser pointer for the dog. Also, check the dog's vision. Also, whether the dog's going after a shadow or a squirrel, right? Or a tennis ball, it's all the same theoretically, all right? Now, what you could do is never go out in the sun and turn all the lights on in your house. That would fix the problem. And believe it or not, some trainers would probably recommend that. So what I would do is this though, going after a shadow, put your dog in down, put your dog in place, create a lot of shadows, correct your dog for going after them. Next.
Pauline, hey Jeff, your dogs are obviously very well trained. Do you create them when I'm unsupervised in the house?
My dogs are actually not as well trained as people think. And I'm fully full disclosure on that. I absolutely crate my dogs. My dogs aren't house dogs. Let's keep that in mind. So I've got working dogs that are not house dogs. My dogs are primarily outside dogs. They travel with me 24/7. And like right now they're in the house for everybody. Sorry, but everybody on Spotify, SoundCloud, iTunes. So they're not tired, by the way. They're just doing nothing on command. So just to let you know, those are three high drive working line dogs. And what I do is everybody on Spotify and SoundCloud and iHeartRadio. Jeez, the internet's going to roll like that. I just showed my three dogs. But yeah, I absolutely crate my dogs. Why? I don't trust them. I don't trust them at all. So they probably would destroy something. And well, why don't I fix that? I do. I put them in a crate. Now, in the RV, Tex is new to me. So Tex is crated, but Kira and Girl are out. And they do fine. But when I leave the RV, Girl gets crated up. Because Girl can deploy through a window.
No, Kira.
I'm sorry, Kira. Thank you. Kira. So Kira tried to go through my front window one day and smashed it. So she gets crated up when I'm not in there. Next.
Mary, do you correct the dog that is shaking and panting in a crate? He is crate trained, nose down in crate with Ecollar. I believe it's part of a protest. He can shake and pant forever. How long I'm gone?
Well, you can't correct, as long as the dog is lying down, that's fine. Panting and shaking depends. You can use low remote stim. If his head is up, you can teach the dog to put his head down. You can do it. It's called the double down or head down. Get them to do their head down. But when you're out of the house, you can't. So you role play it when you are home. Next.
Karen. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. When playing fetch with my dog, he'll bring the ball back many times, then just leave it where it lands. Is this being stubborn? Should I correct for not bringing it back? Thanks.
No, I mean, it could just because your dog doesn't know how to fetch, like just do a retrieve. I don't train retrieve. My dogs just retrieve because they got high ball drive and I'm the guy with the stick. You know what I mean? I'm the guy with the chuck it stick and they're the ones with the ball. And the only way that ball gets to fly through the air is by bringing it back to this guy. So that's the only reason, but I don't know how to train that. They just did it. You know, they just did it. But your dog might just be done with the game. Might be just done with the game. But you can teach forced fetch. And you can also teach send outs. That's more along the hunting training and the service dog training. I don't know how to do that. That's above my skill set. Next.
Greg says, gotcha. And I assume you can tap into your cameras via Wi-Fi?
Correct. Next. Yes, technology has really, really changed dramatically now. You can actually get like Nest stuff as well. Next.
David Smith, you've said this before, but I can't find it. When using both e-collar and prong is higher on the neck.
Yeah, I usually put the prong higher on the neck. There's some photos every once in a while, like especially at a seminar where it's not. I just might be like configuring it. Because the prong collar will get you directional control. Next.
Jamie, hi, Jeff and Joelle. Do you have to adapt your training methods according to breed or is a dog generally a dog? Thinking dogs like greyhounds and huskies that are notorious for poor recall?
Well, huskies are not notorious for poor recall. Huskies recall up fine. Greyhounds have been in the news lately because Florida just banned dog racing, which I don't comment on the news, but I'm not going to look at this from the news. This is a sport, and I'm actually highly against their decision to do that. And some people might be like, oh, no, you know, they were treated poorly. Okay. Well, if they were treated poorly, the state of Florida has animal abuse registry. Okay. Every county in the state has an animal abuse registry, I imagine. And if you really truly feel that a dog is being improperly cared for and abused, well, then you would call them up and you would report it. But there is none. Like nobody's on it. These are sporting dogs. So it's a sport. They love to do it. Like, let's ban soccer and football and triathlons and biking and running and let's tennis and let's just start banning like sports in general. So dog sports are not abusive. So greyhounds running are a fantastic sport. If you're against betting, well then let them do it without betting, but that'll stop it because it's expensive to run these dogs and to take care of these dogs. And yes, I'm sure there are greyhounds that are abused, but they're highly monitored. They're highly monitored. So now what you've got is you've got thousands of dogs that are pretty much most likely going to be killed. And I know it's like, no, they'll go to adoption places. No, they won't, because there's not enough of them. And nobody wants a bunch of greyhound dogs. There's only so many people that want to be like, I don't want a greyhound. Like, most people don't want greyhounds. So they're already overfilled. But greyhounds, we train on recall. But yes, you have to be careful with a greyhound because their burst of speed is incredible. Next. But no, we don't get a lot of greyhounds to train. We don't usually train the sit with a greyhound. Greyhounds have a hard time doing a sit. But pretty much as a pet family dog, no, we train them all the same. Next.
Holding on dog training, inspiring speech, rock on, Jeff.
I gave a speech? About greyhounds?
About seminars.
Oh! Oh, thank you. I've got, you know, words of wisdom to express to all of you. To all of you. You know, I'm trying to teach. Thank you so much.
I don't even know where that rant came from.
Okay.
Because I was put on the spot. I couldn't speak.
You don't know what it is this. I don't plan for any of my shows. I don't plan for my seminars, by the way. Did you guys know that? I don't plan for my seminars. And you've seen them. I have no idea what I'm going to talk about. I'm just like, hey, guys, bathroom's over there. Cell phones are off. Breaks at 1. We're having pizza. We have vegetarian. But if you're gluten free, tough shit, bring your own fucking lunch. Like, that's my speech. And then I'm like, okay, let's go. Tell me about your dog. Bring it up. Boom, we go. Like, literally, that's how I do my seminars. So, true. Yeah, next.
Regal Mommy. Are there certain assessments that you use when first meeting a dog?
No. We're just like, I mean, every dog we meet, we know, we've talked to the owner about. So we don't do assessments of the dog. We assess people. If you can get your dog to us, we'll train it. So we know about the dog. And then we just take the dog from the owner. And then the owner leaves. And then we like just start training the dog. We know what the behavioral issues are. But we've worked with so many dogs, we can pretty much tell right off the bat what's going on. Next.
Tiffany, I was training at Lowe's today. Some lady with out of control doodle came rushing up for her dog to meet my dog. I said, not today, we're training. She called me rude. I thanked her.
Well, that's okay. That's on her. But guys, let's not have dogs meet at Home Depot, at Lowe's, at Tractor Supply. Why? They'll stop allowing dogs in there. It's not a place for a meet and greet. All right, next.
Double Agent says it's a show line.
It's a show line. So it's a show line. I'd actually look for a working line. Show line, the show line dog, the show line German Shepherd in the United States has been destroyed. Now, show line people and breeders aren't going to think so, but then they're just ignorant and they're living like even the judges were like, Westminster were like, what the fuck are you guys doing to these dogs? Like, I mean, I'm pretty sure some shit went down in the AKC, and I don't follow the AKC. The AKC is not a big fan of them, but they were like, what the hell is going on, German Shepherd show people? You really fucked these dogs up. So, and we see it. We see dogs pre-1 year old with hip dysplasia. I mean, we see it. Like, it's like, what are you guys doing with these animals? So I'd go with a working line dog next, especially from Europe. Next.
Mel, sorry, my question is now, what can I do to reverse the improper e-collar use? I'm at my wit's end with my dog. She was never like this before. Can I stop the bad behaviors and how? Thanks.
Yes, you can, but it also might be, it might be coincidence to age. It might be. I think she said it was 18 months old, right? Rottweiler. Mm-hmm. So it might be like your dog's coming into maturity. There could be a lot of things. It also could have been the dog could have had a bad experience with it, like going after a dog or dog going after it. It might not be remote collar related. Just as someone that has worked with thousands of dogs on remotes and seen a lot of fucked up animals, you know, but yes, you can do it. So you'd want to start all over again with food and the remotes. More that I can get out on this show, you'd want to do a Skype session with me next. But yes, you can fix it. You know why? Because your dog could have ended up like that without the daycare. Did I just interrupt you again? Sorry. I watched one of the show backs because she makes me watch my shows because she's starting to like pull clips. And I'm like, gosh, I'll say next and then interrupt you. Next and then interrupt you. So that's the first time I actually realized that I did.
Conscious of it.
I think it's almost like I've got next is Tourette. That's like my Tourette. So what I would do is we see most messed up dogs that have never had a remote collar on. So we see dogs just like yours that have never had a remote collar. So yes, it can be fixed. Next.
Right. Double Agent says, can it be a protection dog?
I don't know. I don't train protection dogs. I wouldn't get a show line dog to be a protection dog. I would start with a working line dog. But then you need to, like I said, you need to find a, if you want a true protection dog, you need to talk to a protection dog trainer. They would take a look at the dog and they would give a proper assessment. That's out of my skill set. But I don't think you want a show line dog. Next.
Grant paid $199. We're not getting notifications.
That one I didn't get.
Isn't that so weird?
What does he say?
He says, one of your proudest moments in your career.
Are you talking about me?
Wait. I like this. He's getting deep tonight.
This is me?
Yeah, you.
Oh, me? Proudest moment is in my career. I don't know if I've had it yet. Gosh. I mean, I've had milestones, Grant. That's a good one, buddy. I might have to send you your money back. Let's see. Having children is a very proud moment. I think being able to meet payroll every week is proud because I love being able to employ people and knowing that in order for me to employ people, I'm in a voluntary transaction business, which means enough people are hiring me to cover my bills. My mind doesn't think that. Maybe I'm still waiting for the proudest moment in my career. Maybe I'm still waiting for it. I'm not holding anything back, Grant. But that's what I got for you tonight. Next.
Megan. Hi, guys. Hey, Megan.
Megan, we love you. Did you move yet? Next. She's avoiding me. She's avoiding me.
I don't blame her. Keep avoiding him, Megan. Chris. Hi, I have a 9-month-old lab, and every time we take him out of his crate to take him out to potty, he will grab anything he can to get his mouth on and take it with him down to go out. How to stop this?
Get yourself a bonker. Well, first of all, put him on a leash and just tell him no and just pop the leash. That's what I would do. Or get yourself a bonker, tell him no and throw the bonker at him. But I would just correct it with a leash pop. Next.
Anna, dog is great on leash and used to love every dog he saw. He still likes dogs off leash and is great at festivals, etc. But he goes on high alert, reacts with one-on-one situations, normal walks, ideas.
Yeah, train your dog to not do it. Most dogs on a leash, it's a leash. You can't do a proper greeting. A leash is a restriction. So what you want to do is your dog shouldn't be meeting anybody on a leash ever. So it also because your dog is also, it depends how old your dog is. So if your dog is like, started out doing great and now is between, and then all of a sudden turned a year old and then maybe 18 months old and now went into full maturity. It's possible you're seeing more of the real dog. Also, if you're giving your dog too much affection, not enough rules, not enough structure, too much freedom, you end up with a badly behaved dog. Not any consequences for inappropriate, even just pulling and inappropriate other behaviors, you end up with these problems. So what you want to do is start watching all of our videos, how to walk a dog properly on a leash. And I want your dog to actually ignore everything on a leash. Literally ignore. I don't want your dog to get excited to see people, excited to see dogs. I want you to stay focused on the task at hand, which is the walk. Next.
Nicole, did lots of play, so now that is my dog's default activity without any command from me. She just lays on one of her beds. Is that too much freedom or is it okay as long as she isn't an a-hole?
Not being an asshole is a pretty good quality both in humans and dogs. Tell her what bed to go to. Next. Mm-hmm. But congratulations. Next.
Tiffany, greyhounds are bred to race, treated way better than your average pet owner dog. Shame on Florida.
Thank you, Tiffany. Yes, Shame on Florida. Next.
Stay epic. Hello. I have a 7-month-old German Shepherd, and on a harness, he wants to be the leader. Also in public, I can't get him to walk anywhere. He's afraid and he will just sit. What can I do? Prong.
Okay. So stay epic. You're brand new to my world. I didn't recognize your name. Welcome to the journey. Go down the rabbit hole. I will never suggest using a harness unless you want to do weight pull or tracking or protection work. When I put my dog on a harness, Kira, she starts pulling. Why? She'll follow a track or go into protection gear in protection mode, depending on what command I give her. So what I want you to do is get a prong collar. I've got a video on how to pick one out and size it, put it on, introduce it, and start using it. Next.
Karen, pop two.
Now you're speaking my language. Next.
Lindsay, what's the shirt status?
We're coming up with 3 designs to start, 3 slogans, 3 designs, shipping by the 1st of December, hopefully. Next week, we meet with a screen printer to go over it. We're doing men and women. She wants tank top. It's like, no, everybody doesn't work out at the gym like you do. Next.
I'll order my own then.
You can order your own. Yes. $10 super top chat. Dobie Mom. Love you, Dobie Mom. Beautiful image of a dog. Next.
Gal Jez, can I start using a prong collar on 12-year-old dog or is it too late?
No. If your dog stopped breathing, it's too late. Next.
Heather S., that's a t-shirt idea. Next. Could be.
Write that one down. Next.
I won't forget that one.
Jeff Gellman. Next.
Marnie, cool dog. I noticed the next thing. So it's not just me.
I never noticed it at all until I watched my video and I'm like, God, how annoying are you, Jeff?
Mel, how do I do a Skype session without a credit card? E-transfer? I'm in Canada. Nowhere near you or I would be there.
So Mel, we don't do e-transfers here. We're in the U.S. You guys, it's funny. I go up to Canada twice a year to do seminars. And everyone's like, can I e-transfer? If you don't have a credit card, what we can do is we'll figure something out. What you want to do is go to my website, Solid Canine Training. Go to the shop. You can buy a 30 or 60 minute Skype session. See if that helps you out. See if you get some help on that. They might be able to help you out right there. If you can't, email my office. We'll see what you can do. Next.
Blue on black. I wished I lived near you so I could come in discreetly, pretend my dog had a problem, just to fix your pictures behind you on the wall without you noticing my pocket square.
So blue on black, this is my home. The chances of you getting into my home are very slim to none. Because I am in the United States, which means I own guns. So between security, an outside dog, the guy with the guns, inside dogs, if you can get to my room to fix my squares, my you can fix these, okay? I'll let you. Next.
Josh, can't wait for the t-shirts, by the way.
Next.
Melissa, she said, buy a prepaid Visa gift card and use it like a credit card.
Wow, Melissa. Thank God you're the smart one in the group. Thank you, Melissa.
You go. Thank you, message. I've been watching and studying from your videos. I have 2 Aussies littermates who don't like strangers and some dogs. I train them Ecollar, heel separately first. And today I decided to take them both for a walk. They were kind of excited at the door. I bonked them one time. They were like, oh shit, LOL. But guess what? They followed me for an hour in peace.
Yuko, I gotta say it. You're a motherfucking badass. Had to be said. Someone had to say it. Can I get a hallelujah? Can I get an amen? Guys, this freaking towel here, it's called a bonker. It's a towel. The pre-bonk before the walk for the slightest bit of nonsense has been a game changer. We're putting together a video now. Keep an eye out for a video titled Serious. Maybe we'll tell you, Serious? Are you serious? Because it's Serious, S-I-R-I-U-S.
Yeah, like radio.
Serious? Are you serious? This 1-year-old German Shepherd dog pulled its owner down. She had $50,000 worth of surgery 33 physical therapy appointments. And she's been struggling for a long time. She came to my seminar. Dog couldn't be around dogs. And it was around dogs. And she can walk her dog in 2 days. I wish she would have met me 6 months earlier. Next.
Let's see. Melissa, she posted the link to your Patreon page.
Oh, thank you. Join Patreon. You'll get more help.
Dobie Mom, great event last weekend. Thank you so much for answering emails and great training.
Dobie Mom, really beautiful dog. Woo! That Doberman was stunning. Mm-hmm. And it's domestic. That's not even imported Doberman. Its parents are imported. That's a U.S. bred Doberman. Stunning, stunning animal. I work with a lot of Dobermans.
Got some good pictures of it.
Yeah, the pictures are going up. That's my job tonight.
Yeah, that's
after job. This, I got to put photos up next.
Lisa, when correcting unwanted behaviors, for example, nuisance barking, how do you decide which tool to use for punishment, bonker or e-collar?
Barking, I usually do with electronics. Why? Chances are the dog's barking not around you. It's a lot easier to do it. Next.
Yuko, thank you so much. Solid canine training. You helped us.
Oh, awesome. Proud of you.
Melissa posted the link to RV Dog Trainer. Yeah. Dog, I crate my dog while at work. She's really excited when I first let her out. When I get home, best way to calm her down?
Put her on a leash. Tell her to knock it off. Got it? So what you do is this. Put the dog on a leash. Open up the crate door. If the dog tries to rush out, slam the crate door in the dog's face. You ain't going to hurt the dog. Trust me. The dog probably pushes against it even harder. Open up the door. Dog tries to rush out. Boom. Slam it again. Open up the door. Dog pauses to wait. Put a slip lead on your dog. Call your dog out. Put it in a sit. Put it in a down. And then send it back in. Have it come out. Send it back in. Have it come out. Guys, we practice sit, down, place, recall, heel dozens, hundreds of times. Do we practice going in and out of the crate? Nope. Practice going in and out of the crate. Next.
Chevy, t-shirt shipping to New Zealand.
Yes, I'll bring you one when I come over to visit. Yes, we'll ship them there.
Josh.
I think.
Next. Sorry, I interrupted you. Josh says, do tank tops also please? I'm with you, Joelle.
Josh, nobody asked for your opinion. Pipe down. Next.
Becky, no questions tonight. Thank you both for all you do. Just signed up for the March Providence seminar. Can't wait.
Oh, you're going to love it. That's a fun one.
That's a fun Next. One.
Is the pool going to be open in March? January, February? No.
Be frozen.
No.
Yeah. Nicole, you do the next thing with Linda too. Oh, the next thing.
Oh, yes. I was like, what? Whoa. Is
that... What's the next thing?
Okay. I call it fucking. I mean, what are you talking about? Okay, next.
Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. Would you ever come to Atlanta, Georgia for a seminar?
I would love to come to Hotlanta. I'd love it. Find me a location. I will be there. I love me some Hotlanta. Next.
Tammy, what is your indication that a dog does need medication, such as Xanax?
I love that airport.
It is a nice airport. It's you get to take the little thing around.
I love it. That's a great airport to people watch in too.
Yeah.
It really
they
is.
They all are.
Well, they all are, but Atlanta's nice. Really good. Yeah.
Clean.
Yeah. What's the question? I would never recommend Xanax. So I would say that not every dog, you got to come off drugs to come to us. I wish I could say the same policy about the employees, but that's just a joke, sort of. So, what you guys do on your own time is none of my business. Okay.
I don't have any free time.
Okay. So what I want you to do is, we recommend, we get dogs off drugs. 99.9% of the dogs, I think 3 dogs this year had to go back on drugs, low dosages. We recommend CBD oil. I've never seen drugs fix anything. I'm seeing Prozac really fuck up dogs, to be honest with you. Mm-hmm. $4.99 super chat. Ecollar broke sock stealing. Hold on. Ecollar, comma, broke sock stealing, counter surfing, tortoise harassment, and more. 3 weeks. Listen to Jeff. Glad you're always happy to see me. David, man. Look at that.
That tortoise story was hilarious.
Did we ever make a video over that? Can you find that and make a video?
That's the first time we ever met David.
Could you make a video? This is before we were making
them. I don't even know what episode that was.
You have to look back.
God. That was funny.
Yep. Next.
All right. Dobie Mom says, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I ski Big Sky. Is it wrong to take my one dog to the dog park and leave the other in the car?
It's wrong to take that dog to the dog park. I'm anti-dog park. It's only wrong if it's 100 degrees outside or 80 degrees outside. you can do whatever you want with different dogs. Do you know what I mean? You can do whatever you want. Like, but this is the thing. I can't stand a dog park. But as far as like, is it, I guess the question is it bad to do one fun activity with my dog but not the other? It's fine. Next.
Allie Wynn, I did get your email. Beyond thankful and excited. I have three friends that desperately need your help, hoping to get them to come too. I know once they see Raji, is that how you say it? After training with you, they will be sold.
Well, I think they should just see my videos. I mean, this is Allie. You don't want Allie? No. Allie, no. I'll have none of that. I don't want you to use your dog as a sales pitch for me. If your three friends aren't smart enough to realize that they need help, well, then you don't want to be helping them. And I'm serious here. If they can't go to my videos, first of all, they might hate me. Like, a lot of people are turned off by me. And if you're wondering why, open up your ears, you know? So, you know, go ahead. Somebody can say it. We'll open up your eyes. Okay, I get it, okay? So this is the thing. What I want you to do is, they should be able to freaking figure it out if they need dog training or not. Come on now. Make it a good, this is what I want you to do. You invite them, you have them all go, you get an Airbnb that's dog friendly, all right? Get an Airbnb that's dog friendly. You actually can keep your dog at our place. They can't, but you can because you're a client. So get them to go, get an Airbnb, do a girls' night out or whatever. If they bring boys, girls and boys' night out in Providence, we got restaurants that are to die for. We have some of the best restaurants anywhere. All right, we got fun. If you're into the nightlife, we got nightlife. Just do that. Next. Joelle, she'll go out with you too.
All right. Where are we? Grant Noble for $1.99. He says, can I? Can I get a shirt with a
Can you resemble some sort of professionalism here?
With a fecal float logo. That was from the last show too. Sorry.
We want you in Atlanta, Pet Lodge in Alpharetta. Dobie Mom, reach out to them, see if they're interested. A lot of training facilities don't like me. Next.
Sarah, just watch the vegan dog food clip and I'm cracking up. I laugh every time I say sunflower seeds. So does Joelle. Priceless.
Thanks, Sarah.
David Smith, that was my first chat. LOL.
Do you remember when it was, David? So she can look for it. And we want to make a little video on that one.
That was a long time ago.
I know.
Jamie Lee, we adopted a dog a few months back. He's a 3-year-old shepherd lab mix. We are working on separation anxiety, but he still whines constantly and sometimes skips meals. Any suggestions?
Well, skipping meals are, I mean, that's not uncommon for a dog to do. As far as separation anxiety is concerned, watch my separation anxiety video. The way to stop whining is through the proper application of punishment. You're gonna have to get a remote collar for that. All right. So next.
David Smith says, I think it was live 458 or 468.
All right. We can listen to both. Thanks.
Marvelous Maker, is a fecal float something you add ice cream to?
No, it's not. You have to watch. Was it last week's? No, it was the one at Chris and Sandy's with shirtless.
Yeah, it was our last episode.
471?
Mm-hmm.
471. Watch episode 471. Okay. That was a good one. Yep.
C.M. McDonald says, LOL.
Yep.
David Smith says, Joelle's laugh makes me happy.
I know.
Aussie K, say fecal float 10 times really fast.
No, she can't say it once.
I can't say it once.
And we need to move on with this show.
Ron, hey J&J, it's Ron from the STL. Question, my GSC is sniffing all the time, so I'm using Ecollar. Is that the right thing to do?
Sniffing all the time, like, does it have a cold or it's sniffing the ground? Yeah, you can do that on the ground. Thanks.
Done?
Yeah, next.
Okay. Jamie Lee, thank you. I appreciate the advice. Blue on black. Sorry, my comment wasn't meant like that with the pictures. Nothing to do with going in your home at all. Maybe a culture difference, not American. Just people can be worse than dogs.
Blue on black. I knew exactly what you're saying. You just don't appreciate my humor. I was busting your balls. These pictures, just to let you know, these pictures are crooked on purpose. I literally make them crooked on purpose.
Yeah, that one's like overly exaggerated.
That one is, I don't know how that one got like that. But I do so, like, see the other two next to it? These two right there? They're crooked on purpose, just to drive my OCD fans crazy. Next. But no, I got what you're saying. It could be a cultural difference as far as my humor. So I wouldn't shoot you. Well, if you came out of my property, I'd have to, because, you know, I've got no choice. Next. But anyway, it's all a joke. It's all a joke. Next.
Sure. Yes. Okay. Sarah, attended your seminar a year or so ago, thinking of coming again in March. Do you have a lot of repeat seminar attendees?
You tell me. Especially if you're female.
Yeah, I'm going to start a group for all of them.
Yeah.
I'm one. I mean, I came and he never got rid of me.
There's quite a few people that I think the record is 4.
Who's gonna make 5?
The record is 4. The record driving to me is 36 hours across all of Australia, from Perth to Cairns. Somebody packed up her whole family, her husband and her 3 kids, and drove 21 hours. That was her second time at one of my seminars. And literally her husband and her had to take care of the 3 kids all weekend, which is not a big deal for a parent to do, but it's like we didn't want to go to the seminar. Like, we don't want to drive 21 hours there and then 21 hours back. But I get a lot of people that go to a lot of my seminars. Yes. More than one. Next.
Holding on, dog training. Atlanta is only a 5+ hour drive to your upcoming seminar in Florida. Well worth that drive.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, if you're in Atlanta, go to the Florida seminar. We just announced the Florida seminar, guys. RVdogtrainer.com. It's close to Orlando, close to Gainesville, close to the Daytona Beach area. So it's right by Ocala Forest. Next.
Jane T, when on a structured walk, my dog jumps forward when she hears a noise from behind her. Should I ignore this and walk on normally or correct?
No, correct it or else it won't stop. Remember, the lack of no is always yes. Next. That should be a t-shirt. Next.
I think that's on the list. Okay. Melissa, fostering a privately owned dog until it's adopted. I don't know the owner. Should I get something in writing like an agreement or contract?
I don't know the owner. I don't understand. It's not, there's no, is there an owner or not an owner?
Privately owned dog until it's adopted.
Oh, I see. So it has an owner. You're the foster because it's trying to get adopted out. Do you want to return the dog to the owner? If you don't, have them turn the dog over to you. Have them transfer the ownership of the dog to you. But if you don't want to keep the dog, so if the dog doesn't get adopted out, you want to give it back to the owner? Well, then my question would be is like, why do you have the dog in the first place unless they want to get rid of it? So I don't know the situation. But if this dog shouldn't go back to the owner and you're willing to keep it, whether it gets adopted or not, have ownership transferred. Next.
3C Canine Training donated $2. Says, thanks, you guys, Dan and Gracie.
Oh, awesome. Dan and Gracie, thank you so much.
And
why am I getting these?
I didn't get one either. I just happened to see it pop up.
Yeah.
Andy B, I will try to book a Skype session and I'm planning to attend the Indiana seminar 2019 just because I want to meet you guys and I can always.
That's a fun one. They have an indoor swimming pool that's heated. We teach dogs how to swim. Next. Mm-hmm.
Dobie Mom says bonk the pics and they will straighten up.
Dobie Mom.
Clever.
That was really funny.
Leanne, hey Jeff, proud owner of an 8-month-old Akita. She likes to bite us when she gets really excited. It was cute when she was a puppy, but now it hurts. Any suggestions? You're the best.
So, Leanne, that's my line. It's cute when it's a puppy, and then it doesn't become cute. So, in hindsight, we stop puppy biting as soon as it starts, which is usually 8 weeks old. I literally punish dogs at 8 weeks old for biting, so they don't bite me anymore. So obviously you've got an Akita. I've owned Akitas. That doesn't make a difference. There's a lot of breeds I haven't owned. But what I want you to do is the only way to stop any behavior is through the proper application of punishment. So number one, what we want to do is if your dog is biting you because when you get it all riled up, you got to make sure that you've got control over that. So if you're going to get your dog all riled up but not have control of its mouth and its body, you have to be careful about doing that right now. Now, I don't do this under threshold bullshit. I want your dog to be able to get as riled up as possible and control itself. So I would actually use a bonker. So a bonker is a towel, and you would say no and then bonk the dog. But I want also maybe possibly change around your lifestyle and how much structure is in the dog's life. Do you hold accountable? Are you giving more love and affection than rules and consequences? And if you are, you need to switch that, because at 8 months old, this ain't nothing yet. Wait till that dog is a year old. So lots of structure, lots of consequences for unacceptable behavior. Train the dog to know all of its basic commands. Crate the dog at night. Crate the dog when you're not home. No free roaming. Make sure you have a great way to apply punishment to the dog. And then stop all unwanted behaviors. Proper exercise, proper diet. Next.
David Smith, I was going to mention the pics are different in every episode.
No, they're not. They're the same. We haven't changed the
picture. That one is super crooked up there.
Oh, the crooked. Yeah. That's probably because when my door closes, the wall shakes. The house was built in 1903. I don't know. But it's a pretty quiet house. I mean, I'm the loudest one in the house. Next.
Angie B, coming from Austin, Texas.
All right, Angie. Next.
Woo-hoo. David C, filled out a shadow form.
We're going to be in Austin in January. Yeah, I got a private... I think we're allowed to videotape it. We're allowed to document it. So I get hired by companies. They fly me out there. They fly me out there to do consulting. I think it's a three-day consulting gig. And we just booked it today. We got paid today.
Cool.
So, yeah. So I'll be up there in January in Austin, Texas. Well, actually, not in Austin. I fly into Austin. And I got to buy the tickets this week. And I can't divulge the name of the company because it's a private company. So, yeah. I'll be there. I like Austin. Next.
David C. filled out a shadow form on your site last week. Haven't heard back yet. Shall I keep waiting?
No, I'd be pissed off right about now. It's like, what the fuck? What kind of professional organization are these guys? Got it. Write down David C.
Got it.
Yeah. That's not acceptable. Even when I'm on vacation, I get my emails. Let me take a look to see what's going on. Next.
David Smith, Phoenix, Southern California, New Mexico, etc. I'm there. Love to meet you. Hope Rocky totally breaks down so he gets real help. LOL.
So Phoenix, I usually do. Ramona, I had one booked. New Mexico. I've never done a seminar in New Mexico. David, find me a place to do one. I'll do one. Next.
Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. You could do the seminar in Piedmont Park.
Nah, I don't like to do. I don't do them in public places. I only do them in private facilities. Only do them in private facilities. It's a two-day seminar. I need electricity. I need toilets. I need enclosure. It's private. If Piedmont Park is a park, but if they have buildings for rent, then I have to be careful about that too. If it's a building that anybody can rent, there's a group of haters. What they do is they try to close down every one of my seminars. That's another thing for all the people that want to do seminars. What do you think it's like? Try doing a seminar in the UK. Woof. My buddy Sean and I, we did a seminar in Scotland and in England. The one in England, we had a file pre. We got four locations shut down. We had a file police reports. We got death threats. I got a lot of anti-Semitic threats. But I'm just going over there to train some dogs. Like, yeah. But guess what though? We did it. And guess what else? I'm coming back. Yeah. I'm coming back. I love it. Wherever the belly of the hate is, that's where I want to land. I want to parachute right in. I want to parachute right in. And I want to be like, let's go, guys. Yeah. UK is struggling. UK is struggling. Next.
Sarah, a nervous dog tries to flee when passing reactive, energetic dogs on a walk. Should flight be corrected, punished with Ecollar?
Yeah, I would correct flight, but I would actually move away. And if there's a dog that's out of control, I move away from them with my dogs. I'm not interested in that. I don't need to show that my dogs can walk by out of control dogs, because I don't trust them. Trust that the owner got a grip on it, or the dog won't come unleashed, or the owner won't drop the leash. Next.
Allie Wynn, totally agree with you. Just showed my friends your content yesterday and didn't plan to push past that.
Good. Thank you.
Angie B, both dogs on prongs start pulling once we get closer to home. Keep correcting.
What I want you to do is one at a time, I want you to watch my 180 move. Watch my 180 move and practice it. It's harsh. It's very harsh, but as it should be. So you're nagging your dogs, most likely, Angie. You're probably nagging them. Like, you're not doing this, but it's like, stop, 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 stop. So it's like, how about this? Cut the shit now. That's the attitude. By the way, guys, when I work with dogs, I'm never angry. I'm never upset. I'm calm. Like, I mean, we all know I have a big mouth, but when I actually work with dogs, it's like I pretty much just do it unspoken. You actually don't need words to train a dog. Next.
Heather S., so many t-shirt ideas. You're not raising a puppy. You're raising a dog.
Heather, write them down and get them to Joelle. She's in charge. Next.
George, hi from Bogota, Colombia.
It's probably Jorge, by the way.
Hi, Jorge.
Thank you. You probably just can't make that little freaking thing there.
Exactly.
It could be George, though. Hey, Columbia, what's going on?
Susan, one of the shepherd portraits used to be more crooked.
Obviously.
He's been straightening it up.
Obviously, somebody snuck in my house and straightened it up. Next.
I ski Big Sky. I need to come to Kalispell, Montana.
Ooh, we do some hunting out there. Let's come out there. We'll do some hunting. Next.
Dolby Mom, belly of hate, here we come, t-shirt.
Next.
Martha. My husband is a saint. We would drive that 20 hours again in a heartbeat. Love you both.
Martha, that's one of the super fans. Martha,
love you.
Martha, I love you. You are special in my life. And I would treasure any time we spent together. Next.
Greg says, so what you're saying is these people have no lives.
Greg, that would be correct.
Their life is to hate Jeff Gellman.
That would be correct. It's really funny, man. It's just so funny because we all know I don't sleep much. And I'm like, so I get up usually at 4:30, unless I'm getting up at 2:39.
1:15.
Guys, if you follow me on Instagram stories, you'll understand. But I get up and I go to the gym. Do you know that we went to the gym? Do we go to the gym 12 out of 14 days or 11?
12.
12 out of 14 days, guys. On the road. Okay.
Here we go.
Listen to this. Everybody's like, oh, it's hard to exercise on the road. No, it's not. You just don't have any fucking discipline. Oh, it's hard to eat healthy on the road. No, it's not. You just don't have any fucking discipline. 12 out of the 14 days, we were at the gym. I mean, ironically, we slept outside of Planet Fitness.
We were just living there.
Yep, in the RV. But then we also, we had one cheat meal. And that wasn't even that bad.
You know, barbecue, and I ordered ordered grilled chicken and shrimp.
But I just thought about that the other night. Actually, it wasn't that bad. Mm-mm. I had chicken. I just had pork. But we also had, oh, you know what it was?
The fried stuff.
It was the appetizers.
That fried.
It was them damn fried pickles.
And chicken tenders and hush puppies.
It was the hush puppies.
Yeah.
But other than that, no way, man.
I didn't even go to the gym today.
Nope.
Too tired.
Next.
Okay.
So the story is, so I wake up early, I'm at the gym and I'm like on the elliptical and I'm like, I'm constantly writing notes. Like, I'm always like, how can I help people today? And I'm like, literally just like, oh, I'll do this and I'll do this and I'll do this. Like, why would you, everybody should be waking up every day, no matter what you do at all. I don't care what you do for a living. It's not about that. How can I change the world in a great way today? Who can I help today? How many people can I help today? Even if you only help one person. Help one person. Do you know that every one of us just helped one person? I think we would eliminate all the issues, right? If every one of us just helped one person. And you sure as hell should be saying hello to people. And like letting people pass in front of you and like helping somebody buy a meal for somebody, buy some socks or a shirt or clothes or a jacket, give someone a friendly smile, sit down and talk to somebody for 15 minutes, 15 minutes of your time, sit down and talk to them. You're on freaking social media for 2-3 hours a day. Literally sit down and just talk to somebody. Just give them your time. That's it. Make them feel like somebody cares. But in order to do that, you really got to care. Next.
I ski Big Sky. I need a new e-collar. Jiggy is an American Bulldog pit mix. 60-ish pounds. What collar to get from you?
You're going to get the, you don't have to buy them from us. I mean, but If you want to, you can.
I like that name.
What I would do is get the Mini Educator. So the Mini Educator 300, we have them on our website, but you can also buy them on Amazon. Amazon will get them to you quicker and cheaper. We'll take one more day and probably $10 to $20 more. Next.
Greg says the seminar shutter downers.
Yeah, I know. My gosh, Greg. Jeez.
Full-time job.
It really is.
Becky, are you still doing your intern program? I'm looking to start my own dog training business and would love to work with you to gain experience first.
Yeah. You got to have some baseline experience because we work with dangerous dogs. But yeah, send me an email, jeff@solidcaninetraining.com. Write something about yourself. Connect me with all your social media. If you have any videos out there, I need to know who you are, what you're doing. You have to be nice. We only want nice people in our company. Next.
Angie B says, thank you. Yep, I'm nagging.
Yep, that's what I thought. Next.
Aussie K, why would anybody hate you? I managed to train my pack with all of your vids and didn't have to waste an effing dime. You're the best because it's free for me.
Aussie K, you're actually being sincere. This is the first time you've actually written me a message that wasn't in all caps. Holy shit. Like, thank you, buddy.
Yeah.
Aussie, thank you. Even you actually lowered your voice and you actually talked to me. I noticed. That really means a lot. And I'm being 100% serious here. Thank you so much. And I'm proud of you. Next.
David.
Yeah, Ozzy, all of Ozzy's like Instagram things.
He cracks me up.
Yeah, everything's always in caps. It's like, holy shit, Ozzy. I like it. Thanks, buddy.
The passion.
Next.
David Smith, also carabiner from prong to the flat. Brilliant. Do it every time now.
Awesome.
Anna, would you teach ignoring other dogs, leave it with the e-collar while on walks or another tool?
I don't teach leave it, but yeah, the same theory. I don't teach leave it. I think leave it's been overused and watered down. But yeah, I would do dog training to answer the question. And then how would I train it? I probably would use a remote collar. Next.
Anna Love, would you teach? Oh, I just read that. Yep. Life with Doberman. My 6-month-old puppy lives in the backyard. He has a dog home, but no crate. Is that a problem?
No. And for anybody out there that nobody's allowed to give Life with Doberman a hard time. I own an outside dog and I live in New England, just to let you guys know to scale this. All right. Dogs love living outside. If I had a bigger piece of property, all my dogs would live outside. And I probably would have even more that ran outside. I would have packs, you know? No, that's a little bit different, but you could contain the dog at night and then give them more freedom during the day. All depends what the purpose of the dog is. Next.
Mary, are you ever coming back to Gilbert's?
Yep. Gilbert's. Yep.
Illinois, would love to do another one of your seminars.
They've banned me from there. If you call the chief of police, his name is Chief Ryder, and give him a call and see if I'm allowed back in the city. Come to Elkhart, Indiana. Elkhart, Indiana. It's very close. It's an hour and a half away, maybe 2 hours tops. Come there. Next.
I ski Big Sky. LOL, Jeff. I don't kill animals. I cried for 2 hours when Miss Bella killed a squirrel.
Please.
You live in Montana and you don't hunt?
That's okay. I will supply food on the table for you. Someone's got to kill the damn animal. Hunting is actually more humane than most animals are killed. But we're not going to get into that conversation. I'll probably alienate a bunch of people.
Yeah. Jorge, my dog should wear the prong collar all the time?
No, technically only when there's a leash attached to it, right? So during training, my dogs are naked. You don't have to be like fully naked. You can have a remote collar on. The prong collar is a tool, sort of like the clicker is a tool. So once a dog becomes, well, that's a bad example because on the walks, why not? It's the easiest collar to train the dog on. After you've trained commands and the dog's under voice control, you probably don't need it. Next. And you definitely don't want to have it on in the crate. Next.
Bug files, always be 1% better than yesterday.
Yeah, that's a good one. Hell, be 0.1%, right? Because then after 100 days, that makes sense. Yeah, after 100 days, you're a totally new person. That could be good. Next.
David Smith, love ya. I run a keto diet group on Facebook and always think about helping and changing lives. You touch many more. Stay strong.
Hey, David Smith, do you listen to Tom Bilyeu? Tom Bilyeu does a great interview Oh, with what's his name? We listened to that last night on the way home, that podcast.
Mm-hmm, probably sleeping.
Yeah, there's a great podcast that Tom Bilyeu does with a somebody that talks about the keto diet in a way that I've never heard before, which I found very, very, very interesting. Next.
Jamie, come back to Scotland, guys. We're not all effing idiots.
Jamie, man, this is the thing. People were like, oh my gosh, how are the seminars in the UK? And I'm like, do you mean the seminars where I did where people wanted to be there? They were great. They were fantastic. I had a great time in England. I love Europe. I had a great time in England. I had a great time in Scotland. And I'll be back next.
Aussie K says, I remembered.
Yep.
David C. Shadow form I filled out will be under David Waters. C on here is for previous last name I had. On third last name, sorry for confusion. I have some experience. Shall I send social media to?
Yes.
Mary, sorry that happened to you in Gilbert's, Jeff.
That's a joke. I'm allowed back in Gilbert's anytime I want.
You have banned from city. I mean, then I didn't question it because I'm like, it wouldn't surprise me.
When I was 16 years old, actually my van, I had a 1976 Ford Econoline van. Green. That was banned from Cleveland Heights, Ohio. But I didn't take them seriously because I was cruising up and down the streets the weekend after. But I was literally told to never come back to their city again. But I'm like, that's back when I didn't respect authority. And I'm like, yep, yes, sir. Yes, sir. And then next weekend, I'm like, Cleveland Heights, here we go. Next.
Haroon 1, how to give a dog a bath in the winter? I'm not allowed to bring him inside.
Oh, I don't know. Dry bath? Why do you need to give a dog a bath in the winter? It's winter time.
Oh, wait. She says, just kidding. I have no dog.
Oh.
We got trolled.
Well, right. At least she didn't say, what do I do when my dog licks his balls? I mean, usually the trolls go a little bit more X-rated than that.
Icy Big Sky says, I'm not against hunting. I just can't do it. I have mushy heart.
You know what we can do then? Let's go hunting with our cameras. We can go hunting let's go hunting with our cameras then. I'm up for that too. Next.
David Smith says,
but you got to bring all the snacks. So if we can't kill them, you got to bring them.
Are you done?
Yep.
David Smith says, I'll check it out.
Thanks.
Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. I have a 4.0 prong for my Akita Husky mix. I was told by my trainer it was the right size, but when I was talking to someone else, they said it was way too big. Advice?
Well, I mean, okay, put it this way. We've never gone bigger than a 3 millimeter. And then I'll let you determine if that was the correct advice or not. Okay? Next.
Mary?
And I've worked with dogs that are upwards towards 200 pounds. Next. Next.
Mary says, hey, your pictures are crooked.
Really? Next.
Oh, God. That's it.
That's it.
Everyone's laughing.
All right. Hans Holt got.
I know. He deleted a lot of messages.
He just put emojis. Yeah. So, Hans, man, you got deleted, buddy. You got put in timeout. Next.
Jorge, my dogs fight if I give them affection at the same time. How can I improve that behavior? Thank you very much. And they are the best.
Hold on. Your dogs are the best? No, they're not. Your dogs aren't the best at all. They're fighting with each other. That's not the best. Are we talking about we're the best? They as in us? Because you're not talking about your dogs. Dogs that fight with each other aren't the best dogs. So they might be good dogs, but they're not the best dogs. If those are the best dogs, I want crappy dogs, frankly, then. So this is what I want you to do. Teach one dog to lie down or teach one dog to go to place. Call a dog over and pet it. If the other dog tries to start any nonsense, you correct it. And then swap them out. Let's find out who the biggest offender is. And the biggest offender is going to get a high level correction. That's what he's got to do. Next.
David Smith says, great show. Again, nothing but love for you.
Thank you so much. Looks like we're not over. Now we're getting a ton of questions. We go to an hour and 30 minutes, technically. So we have 15 minutes left. Next.
That was not told to me prior to this.
I just told you now. Go.
Ice Key Big Sky, have you been anywhere in Montana? Best last place, baby.
No, I have not been to Montana yet. I'll get there next.
Haroon, I would love to hunt, but if I take a gun out in my country, like even in the forest, they will think I'm a hidden killer or something.
Yeah, I know. That's what I like about the United States. Next.
Susan, yes, Jeff, you guys are the best.
Thanks.
Tony, what is your opinion on of side submitting?
I've never done it. I would never do it. And I would never recommend it. Next.
Tony. Oh, I just read that. Jazz. Hi, my dog growls for no reason while resting on the floor. He then gets up and starts barking.
The dog probably, the dogs are probably hearing something that you might not hear. You can correct that. You can correct it. Just tell them no, remote collar to correct it. No, bonker. Next.
Aussie K, my dogs fought before I got the e-collar.
Yep, I know.
Javier, my German Shepherd barks and growls at people while she's in the car. How do I stop it?
Remote collar on the dog. Say no. Correct. All right. So that's the easiest way to stop a dog. All that car nonsense, remote collar. Next.
David Smith, buddy of mine, is on his way to Montana for hunting. I'm jealous.
Nice. Next.
Doug, my dog growled at my wife as she approached him on the couch. Pack issue.
Why is the dog on the couch? I want that dog off the couch. I want that dog in the bed. I want that dog to be no free roaming. I want that dog to hold on one second. Hold on one second. We're getting a bunch of nonsense right now. And I just lost the question. I want that dog to be trained up to know commands. I want that dog to have affection cut out right now. And then I want you to get yourself a remote collar, train obedience on the remote collar. And if that dog ever growls at anybody in that family anymore, I want that dog to be properly punished for that dangerous behavior. Next.
David Smith says, Jay getting sleepy, LOL.
Yeah, she is. Next.
Jorge, you're the best. Thank you for your advice.
You're welcome, Jorge.
Haroon 1, are you a vet?
No, I'm not. But I've got mad respect for all the military men and women. So, no, I'm not. I work with a lot of vets. Next.
3CK.
Wait, hold on. Vets? Are you talking about a veterinarian? No, I'm not. If I was a veterinarian, I wouldn't know shit about dog training. Maybe that's why you asked me, because you don't think I know shit about dog training. So, I'm not. So, I'm not a military vet. Mad respect to the men and women of our fighting forces of the past and the present and in the future. And if you're asking if I'm a veterinarian, a medical professional, no, I'm not. And I will stick to my snide karma that if I was, they wouldn't know anything about dog training. Next.
3CK9 training. So glad I was able to watch a live show. Thanks again, Dan.
Dan, love you, buddy. Thanks.
Ice Big Sky. I'm buying my collar from you. And when you're ready to explore Big Sky, let me know.
Invite me out. Invite me out. Let's do a seminar there.
Yeah.
Yep.
Greg says, oh, yes. Mine have fought over affection before. Jeff gave me the same advice. Worked like a charm.
Yep.
Amanda, love you. How do I Skype properly with you as a trainer?
You Skype, Melissa just put down the link right there. There's the link right there.
Yep.
So Amanda, go down 2 questions, 322 message. That's my Skype information. Next.
Dobie mom, if I correct all barking, will it completely do away with protective instincts? I'm training listen command, wait, bark when it means something. Yes.
So Kira is protection trained, and if she ever barks, I tell her to knock it off. Now, I've got different rules. In the house, she doesn't need to bark. In the yard, she really doesn't need to bark because I have a dog that does bark. Mac is my barking dog for my property. In the RV, if I'm in the RV during the day and I'm driving, no barking allowed. If I'm not in the RV, all my dogs can bark their heads off at environmentals. I really don't care. And at night, they can bark, but because it usually means there's something going on outside. Because I sleep in Walmart parking lots, truck stops, and rest stops. Truck stops can be risky to bark at because we're so close to other trucks. I really don't want them barking. But Walmart parking lots, people should be staying away from the RV. And rest stops, we're usually out in the middle of nowhere. So But the other night, I stayed up most of the night. Where did we park?
Next to Walmart and that
behind fitness. Yeah, behind it, right? Yeah, we parked in a pretty sketchy neighborhood, so I stayed up for most of the night. So next.
Ozzy K says he's a vet.
Oh, awesome. Thank you, Ozzy.
Michael, my dog heels next to me on a bike. If he sees another dog, he stops to pee. I've corrected him at 100 on a dual receiver boss. He still does it.
Fuck. Jeez, Michael. My God. My God. Damn. I thought I had bladder issues. I had to stop in the RV. I pulled over on the side of the highway. Well, how many times? I stayed hydrated. I would just, you know what? I would just keep moving. Even if you got a big dog, I'd have to figure that out. I'd have to troubleshoot that. If he sees another dog and he stops and pees on 100 on a double receiver. Jeez, we use that to stop dog aggression. Is it on snug enough? I would check fit next.
Tammy, I think we need to talk. Maybe Patreon.
Patreon is good. You get a little bit more from me. Just go to join my Patreon channel next.
That's it.
All right, guys. Guys, madly in love with you. It's been a pleasure. We're going to end the show right now. No more questions. I want everybody to know you can go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com. You just go to Jeff Gellman. Just go to jeffgellman.com. Just do that. Make your life easier. Just go to jeffgellman.com. Let's do that. What else can you do? Join my Patreon channel. Just watch a ton of free stuff, ton of free videos. Thank you all for the comments. Thank you for the interactions. Thank you for guys for really, really for interacting with us. Yeah, we stayed at Cracker Barrel one night. We stayed at Cracker Barrel one night. Mm-hmm. Yep. We didn't even stay in the RV spot. We parked along the grass. Having dogs, I usually try to find a spot along the grass. Yeah, that Cracker Barrels are always much quieter because they're closed at like 10 o'clock at night and they're RV friendly. Yep. So. Good point. And there's Cracker Barrels everywhere. It seems like, you know what? It seems like there's Cracker Barrels everywhere, doesn't it? When you drive across this country, it's like, damn, there's Cracker Barrels everywhere. And I'm like, how many Cracker Barrels do you think there could be? I was thinking like thousands of them. I think I looked it up 6 months ago. It was like 645 of them. I'm like, that's it? It's like, I must have passed every single one of them. Yeah, but I guess that makes sense. If they're usually only off of highways, though. You know what I mean? It's usually only off. Like, you don't see Cracker Barrels, like, in malls. That's Cheesecake Factories.
Because they geared towards RVers.
No, they geared towards travelers. But they don't. You go in there, and it's like, those aren't travelers. They're local people.
If you live next to one, then yeah, you're going to go.
Yeah. But
good eating.
What did I get the other night at Cracker Barrel? I got this trout, right? I get trout?
Yeah, you got that.
I got the trout. Oh, if you go to Cracker Barrel, I don't know if they all have that. Right now, they have got, what was that, kale salad?
Oh, the kale and Brussels sprout salad.
Oh, my gosh. The kale and Brussels sprout salad. It's a cold dish.
It's like a slaw.
It's like a slaw, but no mayonnaise, though.
No.
No mayonnaise in it. That, it's one of your side dishes. You get two side dishes, get them both that. Or order an extra one. Ah. To die for. That was really good.
It was.
I loved it. Mm-hmm. That's good stuff. And we had Brussels sprout salad warm somewhere.
Yeah, the thing you bought.
Oh, I made it. Oh.
You will not stop talking about this thing.
I love it. That was good.
If anyone wants to buy Jeff a gift, go to Walmart, buy this little warm-up, like,
no, they've got them
steamable
at, thing. Walmart. They've got them at Stop and Shop.
It's called a Power Bowl.
A Power Bowl.
And it has Brussels sprouts and
kale
and some dressing. And you heat it up in the microwave.
Oh, it is.
You haven't stopped talking about it since.
And then you take yourself, then what you do is you make your protein. So then you take your chicken breast or shrimp or beef. You put it on top. It makes a very delicious meal.
It was good.
Who cooked for you every fucking meal?
You did.
Okay. It's like.
And he made sure I was up and at the gym every day because I wasn't getting up.
It's like you're complaining about.
He's a good travel person. Can't complain.
All right. So, that was good. Nourish Bowl. I'm going to go buy some tomorrow. Nourish Bowl, yeah. I'm going to buy some tomorrow.
Okay. Bring me one.
I'm going to bring them to work. but you can't have them. I'm going to share it with everybody at work but you. Okay. Everybody gets one but you, because you've been criticizing me about those fucking Nourish bowls since I ate them. You've been making fun of me. You've been mocking me.
I eat it too. But I just don't talk about it all the time.
Guys, when you have a good meal somewhere or you discover a good food, don't you talk about it?
I'm not a foodie. I wouldn't know.
Oh, I'm a foodie. What else do we have? Oh, what are the nataki, the mussels?
Oh yeah, I didn't eat those though.
Oh, the mussels dish.
That had some weird mayonnaise.
It's not a weird mayonnaise. It's called Japanese mayonnaise.
But it was like broiled.
Yeah, because you don't eat. You take the mussels, okay, New Zealand mussels. You put the Japanese mayonnaise on it, and then you put something else on it, and you broil it. Oh, woof! That was good. I like trying sushi. I like trying sushi around the world. Probably some of the best sushi I've ever had was in Tucson, Arizona, in this little tiny place. But I haven't been to Japan yet. When we go have dinner with Iris, she's going to take us out.
Yeah,
we won't be able to eat enough meals. No. We have to pick one. Yeah. We have to pick one restaurant.
She knows food.
Let's do breakfast,
lunch, and dinner.
No, we'll do an appetizer crawl. I did that with a family one day. We did an appetizer crawl. Literally like one appetizer at this restaurant, you go to another restaurant, get another appetizer, go to the next restaurant, get another appetizer. Just appetizers. Yep. All right, guys. I'll be in Los Angeles in
February
18th. So I fly in on the 17th. I'll be in Los Angeles. All right. All right, guys. Love you all. Take care. Bye.